early morning when you are the one becoming many, is that is what is waking up state. See, waking up is nothing but one becoming many. When one becomes many, it should always be pleasant. I am becoming many to enjoy me. If you have anger, violence, hatred towards somebody, you will become many only to hurt yourself. Then you will live a demonic life. Become many to enjoy yourself. You will live a blissful life like Paramashiva. One real incident happened in my life. Once I was sitting with Arunagiri Yogeshwara, my guru. Understand, this is very important incident. Listen carefully. Sit straight and listen carefully. I'll describe as it is. One elderly person come into the scene. Why I am calling it as a scene, you know, I always observed within the Dwadashanta, means Arunagiri Yogeshwara gave me darshan as a 6 feet form. Normally, sometimes he will look too big, but 6 feet form is the normal form. I should say maybe 6'5", like that. That is the form. 12 times of his size, his height, like a 12 into 6.5 or 6, roughly. You can keep it as 6. 6 into 12. That many feet, 72 feet. Within that 72 feet, if somebody comes and seen by me also and him also, that person is from Kailasa. He can see us, we can see him. But once he moves from 72 feet, no, he will not be seen by me, but he will be seen only by him, Arunagiri Yogeshwara. And outsiders cannot see him. Listen carefully. That is Dwadashanta, his breathing space is so powerful, no outsider can see him even when I am sitting with him. That is why the temple watchman Rajendran, Tiruvannamalai temple watchman Rajendran, he says, I used to see Swamiji will be sitting and talking alone in front of Arunagiri Yogeshwara's Jiva Samadhi for a long time, morning till evening, but I don't know with whom he is talking. So ordinary people cannot see him. When people walk into his breathing space, if they are from Kailasa, I can see them, they can see me, they can see him. All three can see each other. So one person like that, elderly person, walked in, kept some edible items, like a muruku, some few items. So I was sitting with Arunagiri Yogeshwara and listening to him. He was talking something. After some time, very casually, and I had a very intimate relationship with him. He's literally part of me and I'm part of him. Casually, without him telling me, instructing me, this is the place where I used to usually sit with him. Exactly the place where I am sitting, he used to sit. And I'll sit the next step down. This is the place where we usually sit and have interactions. Listen carefully now. Now let me tell you. Casually, I took that muruku, some items, and put it in my mouth and started eating. He was teaching something very powerful. And he uttered some mantras. Very powerful sound mantras. But I was trying to crush the muruku in my mouth.
because of that murku sound, I did not hear that mantra. So I just asked him, means to repeat the mantra. He is extremely sweet person. He became ferocious and said in Tamil, Thingarada Nirthu. Literally my whole being was shaken. He told, Thingarada Nirthu. It means, literal translation is stop snacking. That snacks, when you eat, that process is called Thingarada. That which makes sound, the murukku and all that snacks, Indian snacks, when you eat, it will make sound in the mouth. So because of that sound, I missed some of the mantras he was uttering. Actually, if you eat murukku, you will understand exactly what I am saying. The sound which your mouth, the sound which murukku makes inside your mouth, you will not be able to hear others talking. So I missed some syllables, some of the Bija mantras, and asked him, means when I just said, it means I am asking him to repeat. I missed the sound, so please repeat. He became so ferocious and very strong screaming voice, Thingarada Nirthu. Fortunately, he has already blessed me with a simple obedience. Just my spontaneous reaction was, I spat the whole thing. Means I just vomited threw the whole thing out. And the next thing I did, I just picked up his finger and put it in my mouth to remove whatever is stuck in my mouth, to make sure it doesn't go inside, it goes outside. So whatever, I took his finger and put it in my mouth to clean, let all that go out, let your instructions be absolutely executed by your grace. I am here with absolute simple obedience. I did not think and do all this action. I just know simple obedience. And no anger, no reaction, no fear, no violence, no resistance, nothing. Actually, he was screaming ferocious with me. I was very romantic. The romance was my response for his ferociousness. Will you have a guts when even your mother or father screaming at you, will you have a guts to pick up their hand and put it in your mouth and clean your teeth? Fortunately, he has blessed me with absolute simple obedience. That simple obedience, I just spat the whole thing, whatever was in my mouth, and picked up his hand, put the finger, and cleaned my teeth, whatever was deep inside, stuck. Two things happened. It just cooled down. His whole response to me cooled down. Of course, surely he's Paramashiva, so the whole space is different, and he was testing me, all that I know. I'm telling you the exact as it happened. And the way he took another hand and held my head with one hand, and actually I took the left hand, his left hand, and put it in my mouth to clean my mouth, to get the small bits out of whatever was stuck in my teeth. So he took his right hand and held my head and nicely cleaned. Like, just it
did here there and whole thing came out and I spat the whole thing. It all happened maybe the whole incident I can say 10 minutes. He said, I was just checking. I know for sure you are in oneness with me. Understand? First, I did not think, let me swallow whatever I already put in my mouth. No. I made a big mess of taking it and putting it in my mouth without his permission. Before he told, I did a mess. It's a big mess. I should not have taken his presence for granted, his teaching for granted, his initiation for granted, and just picked up and put it in my mouth. It was a mess. Big mess. And then when I missed the syllable, the sound, Bija Mantra, he was actually chanting few Bija Mantra in between the instruction to initiate me. And I missed that Bija Mantra because of that Murku sound, Kadamuda sound. When I asked him, when he became ferocious and gave the instruction, literally screamed, Tingarada Nirthu. I did not plan strategically, let me just swallow whatever is in the mouth. No. Simple obedience. Just spat. Next, I have to clean whatever is in the mouth. How much ever I try to clean on my own, it will not be complete. So let me take his help to execute his instruction. Took the finger and put in the mouth. Absolute intimacy and romance. Not, I am very clear, he is ferocious for my good. He is, doesn't hate me or he is not angry with me. Trusting your guru. He is not angry with you. He doesn't hate you. He is guru-disciple relationship. That is the basis for simple obedience. I just know he doesn't hate me. He is not angry with me. He is just training me. And the whole thing only opened up in me as an intense love and romance. So I just picked up his hand, put it in my mouth and started cleaning my mouth, requesting him to help me to execute Guruvak, his instruction. He was ferocious. His ferociousness invoked intense trust and romance in me. That is the source of simple obedience. Simple obedience. Not strategic. Not thinking, oh, let me swallow this much. I will not put next hand in my mouth. Next handful I will not put. I will not take more, but whatever is in the mouth, let me swallow it. No. Simple obedience. No justification. No anger. No violence. Simple obedience. After cleaning my mouth, actually he held with the right hand my head and with the left hand he cleaned. I could see very clearly everything just came out. And I spat it out. He just hugged me. That's it. I know the intense oneness. I bless you all with this oneness, keeping Arunagiri Yogeshwara as a witness. I am bringing that Akashic record from past to present and making it happen with all of you. Let all of you experience this oneness with Arunagiri Yogeshwara. I am blessing all of you, every one of you.